Welcome to our channel DexLab Analytics. My name is Niharika Rai, and in this particular video I will be talking about the intuition behind machine learning. If you haven't subscribed our channel already, please click on the subscribe button, click on the like button during the process of your watching video. If you like this video, click on the bell icon. If you haven't watched my previous video, in my previous video I've explained in detail how you can calculate the values of your intercept and the slope and predict your y values, that is the concept of linear regression. So now, without wasting any further time, let's get started. So before explaining the intuition behind machine learning, let's understand the meaning of the term first, which is becoming so popular in this era of scientific innovation and is a trend that everybody wants to follow. So what is machine learning? Machine learning, if explained in a very layman language, is a program running behind an application which has an ability to learn from what it sees and the errors that it makes, and then tries to improve itself through trial and error. A programming language like Python, you can also use Java or whatever programming language you are using. A programming language like Python and a method of calculation is statistics is what helps propel this application in the right direction. Like a small child, when he or she tries to learn how to ride a bicycle, they fall a lot of times, right? While trying to learn bicycle, right? So what happens is that, like in the same way, whenever, suppose that you have the child is running or riding the bicycle on the same road. Now they know where the bumps are on that road. Each and every bump is known to that child now, and that child who is sitting on this particular cycle, I know the cycle looks weird, but on this particular cycle now knows where the next bump would be. At first, this rider will fall off on the ground and then again with sheer determination try to bridge the gap between or reach the destination where this rider wants to go. So at first the rider doesn't know that there is a bump on the road. They try to learn it, first time they fall and then they realize, oh, there is a bump, and then they remember that there is a bump on the road, and so they skip this bump and somehow try to save themselves from falling and then move ahead. And then again there is another bump on the road, and they fall again, and then they learn that, oh, I have to again start riding, and then they start riding from here, and then they memorize each and every part of this road. And each day the person is riding from this position to this position and trying to memorize each and every mistake they are making. This is what machine learning does. It memorizes, or you can say it tries on the trial and error basis, it tries to learn from its mistakes and then tries to reduce its error. In our case, that is reducing the error of falling because of a bump, because now this child remembers where the bump is in reality on the road. So in this case, the rider or the bicycle rider or the child needs a bicycle to drive or to cross this road in particular. In our case, I know this is sitting on the handle of the bike. I'm sorry, I'm not that of a great picture making person or something like that. So sorry for the bad drawing, but yeah. So in beginning, what happened, this person needs a bike to travel this road, and also needs his sheer strength and energy to travel, right? So there might be 10 kilometers if it's someone adult. Obviously the child won't be able to, even the little child might travel 1 kilometer, not more than that. I don't think the parents will allow them. So yeah, so this is doing a 10 kilometer drive or riding a bike. So what happens is he needs his cycle and his strength and stamina. So in the same case, we need a language in machine learning like Python or R. We need these languages to make our algorithms and then try to perfect these algorithms. And this machine learning algorithm learns from his mistakes, which is made so that the errors can be reduced. Now that you know what machine learning is, let's discuss about what the actual intuition behind the machine learning algorithm is. In my previous blog, I have discussed about a statistical concept called linear regression. Linear regression. Linear regression is a concept which basically helps you predict your trend line and predict whatever, suppose that we have a two columns x and y. It helps you on the basis of x data, helps you predict your y values. That suppose that x is 10, what should be the value of y in this regards? So like that. So linear regression helps you with that. So if you haven't watched my previous video and you have missed out on all the calculations which I have taught in my previous videos, go ahead and watch that video and then come back to this video if you wish to, or you can carry on watching. There won't be any problem in reality to understand this without that calculation, but I would request you to go ahead and watch that video for a better understanding. So I was saying that in linear regression, which follows that given an y independent variable prediction and the prediction of a dependent variable, prediction of dependent variable is possible if we understand the pattern, or the rate at which x and y are changing and the direction in which they towards which they are moving, then we'll be able to predict the value of y in that regards. So the background is that if we understand so we need to understand the hidden pattern which is working behind the trend line or the line of or the prediction of these values. Suppose we have 2 here and 15 here, then 3 here and 25 here. So if we understand the pattern at which, or the rate at which these are changing and the direction, that is, suppose they are, if x changes, the y changes in a positive way, or if x changes, the y changes in the negative way. If we understand that, we'll be able to predict our y values. And in the process, we will be able to reduce the difference between the predicted values and the observed values which we already had. But this is not possible with only calculating the slope, that is beta 1, or the intercept, that is beta 0, that is the slope and the intercept. Calculating these values single time, and this is where machine learning algorithms or machine learning comes in handy. So as I said, the idea behind machine learning algorithm is to understand, to learn from its past mistakes and then try to reduce the error which is being produced or being delivered to us, and reduce that error in the process. So how that is going to happen is by changing the values of intercept and slope until and unless, and the slope until and unless we reach the minimum possible error. So what machine learning algorithm does is that suppose you have your data, here we have X and Y, and this is the basic intuition which we want to follow, that is the reduce the error which is between the predicted value and the observed value which we already have here. So what is a machine learning algorithm does is in a very basic at first in basic terms at first it initially gives a value of beta coefficient, some value to beta coefficients like beta 1 and beta 0, predict the values of y and calculate the error. We know the how the error is calculated, minus predicted y, right? And then it updates these values of these coefficients and looks at how minimum of the error we can reach, how much low we can reach in terms of error. So it changes the value of coefficients, slope and intercept. That means we are experimenting with the rate of change at which X and Y are changing in this regards, and then we are checking how low can we go to find the error, or you can say reduced amount of error which we already have. So it constantly changes and changes and changes and learns from its past mistake, learns from the data, learns from the rate which we have already given previously used, and sees that is there any loss or not, and then gives us the final coefficients after learning all the mistakes and after updating a zillion times or whatever times you're making that algorithm learn, and then gives you the best possible predicted y, that is for 15 what should be the value of y, best possible y's in this regards. So no matter what algorithm you're using in machine learning, the intuition to reduce the error and to increase the accuracy of our prediction remains the same in the back end. All we need to do is, whether your problem is a classification, whether is your problem is of linear regression, all we need is to understand the pattern behind the data which we have and the rate at which it is moving and the direction in which it is moving, and then try to predict best possible values. Now once we have understood what machine learning is and what is the intuition behind it, let's quickly go through what are the branches of machine learning. So machine learning can be divided into three parts: supervised learning, unsupervised learning, and semi-supervised learning. Now, in supervised learning, we pass through two problems, that is regression and classification. And what does this supervised learning mean? Supervised learning is basically when you have both your X values, that is independent data or independent variable, and you also have your dependent variable which we need to predict, and we have, for y we have a function of x, that is in linear regression, that is beta 0 plus beta 1 plus xi plus ei. We have a function to predict our y values. So if we have a function to predict our y values, that is called supervised learning, where we have a y to predict. In case we do not have a y to predict, and this goes for both regression and classification, and in case we do not have our y values to predict, that is, there is no function to predict y, there is no function to predict y, in that case it is called unsupervised learning. In this situation, we only make clusters of our data and see the similarities, whatever there is, low, medium and high. Suppose that we have a blood pressure rate, so lower range values will come under this cluster, medium range will come under this cluster, and high range will come under this cluster. So like that. Now when it comes to semi-supervised learning, this is one of the most difficult part, because in this case we might have a function of x, but we might not have a historical data, that is x comma y. We might not have enough historical data of y to predict our values. So in this case we are having missing values, so the possibility of error in this kind of a problem is very high. Generally in industry we are currently working on supervised learning and unsupervised learning. On semi-supervised learning, companies like Tesla and Google and all that are trying to make the best possible algorithms to study for all of us. So that's it for this video. Hope you found this video interesting and you got some information regarding what the intuition and what the mindset to keep, what type of mindset to keep in mind when you're, you know, working on an algorithm or trying to solve a problem in machine learning. If you want to learn more from us, if you want to learn machine learning from us, please go ahead and click on the website www.dexlabanalytics.com. You can call us on the given number on the screen. You can also WhatsApp us or mail us at hello@dexlabanalytics.com. We are currently placed in Gurgaon, but due to COVID-19 situation, we all are working at home. So that's it. Bye bye. Take care. Love you all.